Jupiter, NASA's expectations have been exceeded by groundbreaking new images of Jupiter. The James Webb Space Telescope at NASA has recently taken some brand new pictures of Jupiter, which have shown previously unseen aspects of the planet. As soon as these pictures are released, many people start wondering if there are any new signs of dark matter. Want to know more? Hey intellectuals, welcome back to the Future Space. Today's video is going to be really informative, so make sure to watch the video till the end because we're going to reveal some secret data about Jupiter. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss any of our amazing videos. The JWST has already sent its first batch of photographs to the scientific community, providing them with an essential insight into the universe's early stages. The first photographs of Jupiter taken by the world's most powerful and largest space telescope have just recently been made public. It's absolutely surprising that we can see details on Jupiter together with its rings, tiny satellites, and even galaxies in one image, said planetary astronomer Imke de Pater. The fact that we can see all of these things in one image is truly astounding. Both of these pictures were taken by the near-infrared camera on board the JWST. This camera employs three special infrared filters in order to acquire photos with an extraordinary level of detail. In order to make images, the data from the camera had to be mapped onto the visible spectrum. This was necessary because the human eye cannot see infrared light. NASA worked with Judy Schmidt, a citizen scientist, to develop visual representations of the data collected by the Webb Space Telescope. Pater remarked, "To tell you the truth, we weren't really anticipating it to be of such high quality." Jupiter is characterized by its ferocious winds, gigantic storms, vivid auroras, and blisteringly hot temperatures. Images of this kind can assist researchers in piecing together information about the planet that takes up the most space in our solar system. Researchers observed the Great Red Spot, a storm so large that it could engulf the entire world, and the high-altitude cloud tops of concentrated connecting storms in the second image. The storm is so large that it could consume the entire Earth. According to Thierry Fouché, a professor at the Paris Observatory, this one image sums up the science of our Jupiter system program, which studies the dynamics and chemistry of Jupiter itself, its rings, and its satellite system. Jupiter isn't the only thing that Webb studies, though. The goal of the space telescope to unravel the mysteries of our solar system and the universe at large is now ongoing. Jupiter's atmosphere revealed, in three dimensions. You are probably well familiar with the fact that it is the largest planet in the solar system. On the other hand, it's also the planet in the solar system with the most extreme weather conditions. Since 2016, the Juno spacecraft has been in orbit around the gas giant, and it is currently in the home stretch of its mission there. The issue is caused by Jupiter's enormous magnetic field, which can be significantly more powerful than the magnetic field of the Sun itself. Because of this magnetic field, charged particles that are moving through space are captured and forced to make a circuit around the planet, much like a little NASCAR race. However, those charged particles are extremely damaging to electronics, and it is unlikely that Juno will continue functioning for much longer. In the interim, scientists will make use of Juno's suite of instruments to investigate as much of the unknown world as they possibly can. They are utilizing onboard infrared telescopes, which are similar to heat vision but are used for astronomy, in order to monitor sources of energy that are located deep below the cloud tops. They are meticulously monitoring the way in which Jupiter's enormous gravity pulls on the spacecraft in order to construct a map of the planet's interior. They are measuring that tremendous magnetic field as well as the variations and ripples that are occurring inside it in order to gain an understanding of what is occurring to charged particles under the surface. The cloud-forming layer known as the weather layer is responsible for giving Jupiter its banded appearance. They have discovered that the storms on Jupiter stem from a deep root system. Consider the Great Red Spot, a lone hurricane that has been active for at least a couple hundred years at this point. The entire storm is wider than the planet Earth, and thanks to Juno, astronomers now know that it extends at least 300 miles down to the planet's surface. That's deeper than the clouds, deeper than the layers of hazy water vapor. Those depths are so far below the surface that the sun's rays will never reach them. The fact that the storm originated there is unexpected and represents a 180-degree turn from the normal process by which storms on Earth obtain their energy. The sun's rays are the primary force behind the circulation of the atmosphere and the development of storm systems on this planet. The heat that was probably preserved throughout the building of Jupiter's huge globe is likely where Jupiter's source of energy comes from. This heat is located deep below the planet's atmosphere. This picture depicts the magnitude and depth of Jupiter's Great Red Spot by combining an image of Jupiter with a composite image of Earth, Jupiter's Great Red Spot. In addition to this, the Juno team found that each pole has its own set of cyclones. Eight storms, each about the size of Texas, are converging in the north to form the shape of an octagon. A pentagonal configuration is formed by five storms in the southern region. The team had the opportunity to see a sixth storm that was making an attempt to join the party in the south, but it fizzled out in a matter of months. Now, it's time to answer some questions. So first, and the most asked question on the internet is, how big is the James Webb Space Telescope? The JWST, which is being hailed as the successor to the Hubble Space Telescope, is the most advanced and expansive space observatory ever constructed. Its enormous sunshield base has dimensions of 22 meters by 12 meters, which is almost the same size as a tennis court. Although it is nearly twice as large as Hubble, which measures only 13 meters in length, the JWST weighs only 6,500 kilograms, making it roughly half as heavy. The gold-plated mirrors on the JWST have a total diameter of 6.5 meters, which is far larger than the plate on the Hubble telescope, which only measures 2.4 meters in diameter. In general, the view that can be captured by the JWST will be approximately 15 times wider than that of the Hubble. Question number two, how far into the future is the James Webb Space Telescope able to look? The JWST Observatory will investigate objects that are more than 13.6 billion light-years away by making use of its infrared telescope. Because it takes light that long to travel across the universe, this indicates that the JWST will be gazing at objects that existed approximately 100 to 250 million years after the Big Bang. This is because the time it takes light to travel throughout the universe is 13.6 billion years. This is the farthest back in time that humans have ever been able to witness. In what region of space will the JWST be stationed? After being propelled into space, the JWST will enter an orbit around the Sun while traveling at a distance of up to 1.5 million kilometers from Earth and in temperatures that can reach minus 223 degrees Celsius. When compared, the distance between the Earth and the Moon is 384,400 kilometers, while the Hubble Space Telescope is only 570 kilometers above the surface of the Earth. If there is a problem with the JWST while it is in operation, astronauts will not be able to fix it because it will be located so far away from Earth. Question number three, what exactly is the mission of the JWST? The JWST is the result of a joint effort on the part of three space agencies, NASA, the European Space Agency, and the Canadian Space Agency. It was designed with a variety of objectives in mind. These are the following. Investigate the origin of the first light in the universe, as well as the astronomical objects that came into existence not long after the Big Bang. Learn how galaxies come to be and how they change over time. The research will be done on the atmospheres of faraway exoplanets. Take pictures of planets that are part of our own solar system. Find signs that dark matter is present. After its initial launch, the JWST is anticipated to be functional for a period of 5 years. However, NASA is holding out hope that the observatory will continue to function into the next decade. Alright, that's pretty much it for this video. Hope you find it helpful. If you enjoyed this video, then make sure you subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell so that you will never miss any updates. Till then, you can also check out our other videos as well, and we will see you in the next one.